Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you doing this fine day? Me? I'm feeling a combination of grateful, happy, and chagrined because for this vlog, for the vlog growing your YouTube channel to 100,000 subscribers, we have passed the 100,000 subscriber mark. So a great big woohoo. Why I'm feeling chagrined, that's where the happiness and the gratefulness comes from, by the way. Where the chagrin comes from is that I haven't published a vlog in this series for quite some time, and that is on me. I should have done that, but it's just been so busy. I've had so many little projects going that this always kind of slips kind of to the back of the queue, and then you get that self-fulfilling prophecy where you haven't done something that you know you should have for a little while, so you're feeling guilty about it. So when you return to it, you feel more guilty than you feel like you're making success. So you put it off again, and it just gets worse. So here I am making an effort. We are going to spend, over the next couple of months, we will publish into this vlog as many of the lessons that I learned in growing our channel to 100,000 subscribers, as many of the tips as I can think of over the next period of time. So let us return today, and today on growing your YouTube channel to 100,000 subscribers, we are going to be discussing the ever-important search. When I look back and I think about what the touch points are that have given me the most traction as far as helping grow the channel. And remember, now the subscribers are really just a vanity statistic. What's really important is engagement, people being migrated to my mail list, those sorts of things. But it is a measuring stick that we can look at and we can say, oh, there is success there, we are getting traction. When I think about the things that have caused, that have driven the most traffic to my YouTube channel and helped grow the channel, nothing does better than search. So paying attention to your analytics and paying attention to your SEO, to your YouTube SEO, is a constant. And it's such a constant that I think some YouTube content creators consider it to be a drudgery to a certain extent. They stop paying attention because it seems like work. Fair enough, it seems like work, but it's work that works. If we go into our YouTube analytics at any point, I'm just going to go in and I don't even know what video I'm going to choose. We'll just look at the channel stats to start. Let's go in and let's take a look at this right here, traffic sources. What does traffic sources tell us? It tells us where people are discovering our videos. And if you take a look here, this is an important thing for me. If you take a look here, 58% of my watch minutes come from suggested videos. From YouTube search, another 21%. Stop for a second. On my YouTube channel, on the Dotto Tech channel, 100,000 subscribers, 76% of the total minutes watched of that channel comes from search or suggested videos. Now, suggested videos are when you're watching a video, those suggested videos which appear in the sidebar. Very powerful. One of the reasons we want to make sure we have great thumbnail images so that we are clickable when we are there in the sidebar and we're not just some random screenshot. Very important. Another 21% comes from YouTube search, from people looking. That's the beauty of YouTube video. You know, when we talk about the difference between YouTube video and these other newfangled video types that are coming, the Facebook video, the Twitter video, my gosh, the Instagram video. Now, I mock it a little bit, but those video platforms are all video being delivered incidentally to a marketplace. People aren't coming and looking for video. It's being served to them by somebody else. When people come to YouTube, the beauty of YouTube and the importance of YouTube video is it's intentional. People come and they look for a video on a topic, search for it, and they come to you. So they come to you already in a mindset to consume your content and to possibly become part of your community. When you stumble across a video, even if it's a good video on Facebook or on Instagram or in Twitter, it is happenstance. You're just stumbling across it. It might engage, but there isn't intention in the process. So the chance of stickiness, the chance of the people actually converting into something in your community, far less if you think about it from that perspective. So 21% from YouTube search and 55% from the suggested video. You know, you go way down and YouTube subscribers, where is it? It's usually in here. I don't actually see it right now. Okay, but you see here that all of the other sources of traffic is a fraction of what we get just from those two criteria. So building your chops as far as SEO goes, making sure you have good search engine optimization and you are findable and that YouTube wants to suggest you, is something that we all need to concentrate on a constant basis. So I guess there's two parts of that equation as far as being searchable and being findable and making sure that YouTube is suggesting you. From the YouTube suggested perspective, what you want to pay attention to is your watch time and your engagement, seeing what percentage of your videos people are actually watching and making sure that that number is a good and healthy number and it's a good percentage of your overall video. What does that tell YouTube? That tells YouTube that when people are searching for the content, that it's valuable, that it's viable content, and that it's worth recommending again for people to view, because when people watch the video, they're generally happy with the video, so they're staying with you. That's number one. So that's where you generate additional traffic through the suggested video and through search for that matter. As far as the search goes, you have to make sure that you do good titles, that you do good tags, and that you create a SEO-rich environment within the comments, within the description field within YouTube. And I have found a tool for that. We'll dive into this tool a little more in a little more detail in the coming episodes. But it's called TubeBuddy, and if you take a look at it, I've got it installed here, and I'm just going to show you quickly how it can help with some of the SEO challenges that we face. So I'm going to go to let's go to this video here on 1Password that I created about a month ago. It's getting, you know, as far as for me, it's getting more than my average amount of traffic for a couple of months, but it's not like blowing the doors off. If I take a look at the different tools that TubeBuddy gives me, one of them is search rankings. Search ranking is going to tell me how this video is ranking in search. Now, you could do this manually yourself by creating an anonymous browser session, then typing, going to YouTube, and then typing in the different search phrases and seeing where your video appears. But that's fairly labor intensive. I think so as well. Here, it takes all of the keywords that we've put in as far as tags, and it tells me how this video is ranking. And look at these. This is what I'm looking for. Number one, number two, number five for password managers. And here the change. It's got like a leaderboard in a golf tournament. It's telling me that I've moved up three in the best password manager search term, but I've moved down one in the password manager search term. Damn you, password manager, I want to be up in number four. I'm going for three, not for six. So you see here, though, why this video is probably doing well is it's ranking quite well in many, many search criteria. Although this one here, it just plummeted in. I don't know why. But going through, checking this, and then modifying your content, modifying your descriptions in YouTube to help boost up its SEO, that's an exercise that's well worthwhile. Now, I'm not saying that you have to do this for every video. Some of your videos are just kind of run-of-the-mill videos, but your star videos, the ones that you know are going to generate traffic and are going to generate interest in your channel, you have to make sure that you do a great job of creating good search ranking criteria within the title, the descriptions, and the tags, and go back and refresh it. As a matter of fact, this tool, I won't show you right now, but this tool will actually go through and help us suggest different search phrases and search terms and tags, which might help us as far as SEO ranking is concerned. SEO in YouTube is a very straightforward relationship. It's not like in Google where you're trying to game the system all the time. If you create good, compelling video, describe exactly what it is accurately to YouTube, they will reward you with traffic. So as far as I am concerned, there's a lot of trust between content creator and channel and YouTube channel, because when I create good video, I'm pretty sure that YouTube is going to celebrate that video and help me get it before not just my community, but other people that might be interested in it. That is the beauty of YouTube publishing. Well, there we go. I did it. I got back on the saddle. I got back on the horse. It didn't seem too painful. And we got another episode of Growing Your YouTube Channel to 100,000 Subscribers out. Now listen, there are three ways that you can stay in touch with me, and I would appreciate you using any of them. The first is please subscribe to this channel. Secondly is subscribe to my newsletter. I often do live webinars on a variety of different topics, from productivity to social media, and you might find them to be valuable. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded channel supported by our friends at Patreon. If you want to find out what's involved with being a patron of Dotto Tech and what perks are included, and the perks are awesome, I encourage you to drop by our Patreon page. Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.